Our next speaker is one of the most eminent economists in the country, currently a professor of economics and director of research at the Lahore School of Economics. His research interests include economic growth, international trade and poverty, on which he has published a great deal of work. Earlier having served as economic advisor to the Asian Development Bank, he has since been deeply involved in policy advisory services to the government, currently serving on both the advisory council of the Chief Minister of Punjab and the Prime Minister's panel of economists. Can you please have on stage Mr. Nawid Hamid?
डाइस के ऊपर ना छोटा सा माइक पड़ा है वो देखो नजर आ रहा
है. थैंक यू फॉर सच अ ग्लोरियस इंट्रोडक्शन. कमिंग आफ्टर मिस्टर अय्यर रहमान, आई थिंक आई एम गोइंग टू बी रादर बोरिंग एंड ड्राई स्पीकर, सो प्लीज यू हैव टू बेयर विद मी. आई थिंक इट्स अ ग्रेट ऑनर टू बी हियर टुडे बिकॉज फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम is seeing at a university in Lund, which has provided the leadership in many other areas, in teaching and in business. Research is one area which has been invested. Undoubtedly, a lot of research has been done, but of relevance to the country and available and disseminated to have an impact, that part has been missed. So I want to congratulate Ijaz and the faculty of this very long main school, as well as Duranisa was saying, long main center, but I'm glad you can call it Civil and Policy Research Center. So, congratulations. I think this is a step in the right direction. We need to create a research culture in this country. We are given to taking decisions on and arguing on anecdotal and casual basis. I know somebody who had one experience and I generalize from that that all the world looks like. And it may make for good conversation, but it makes for very poor policies. And so I think that this is a step in the right direction. And the other thing the center you do, from what Ijaz told me, that you want also to have your undergraduate students working in these teams and doing research in their final year. And this will get them interested in research, and maybe more of them will choose to go into teaching and research as an option rather than business and private sector, which is very good, but still we need more people who are motivated by research. So, congratulations. As has been said, and as your note says, poverty is a multi-dimensional concept. And we can say people are poor if they lack, one, income to sustain themselves. That is the first and most obvious one that we have. Second is access to basic education and health services, or we can even broader basic services. Third is some protection against external shocks, so everybody can have some external shock and there is a need to provide some protection or safety. And fourth, as Ayer Rahman emphasized, empowerment to participate in making the decisions that shape their lives. Because if people are poor, they have no say in the decisions about their lives. Then even if they have are not poor on another count, they still do. But in fact, what we've seen, that these are all interlinked. Without this empowerment of the people, it is very difficult to actually tackle poverty. And without access to education and health services, it is very difficult to develop a labor force which has the human capital to bring you out of poverty. So in some sense, these are the prevention of poverty, but as well as the four elements on which one needs to work on if one is going to pull the country out of poverty. Therefore, multidisciplinary research and approach is essential when talking about poverty, and I'm glad to see that you have all the seven areas and all the different departments in war and destruction. The theme of poverty is particularly important in the context of Pakistan, because that theme of poverty is the same thing as development. They are just two names for the same thing. You can't have a country with dweller which has poor people, which has mostly poor people or very high degree of poverty, and you will not be able to get people out of poverty unless you also dwell. So this is another way or another lens through which one looks at development. And this is the lens which is the more important lens in some ways. Look at it from a people-centric view rather than from the macro perspective. Most of the work done in Pakistan has been on the measurement of income poverty. The focus is on what is the incidence of poverty, and the discussion generally revolves around whether it went up or down in a particular year or year. And that was what Shahir Rahman was saying, that there are so many poor people, it was 26%, somebody said it would come down 16%, and there is discussion of went up in the 60s, went down in the 70s, went up in the 90s, had come down in... But this is really not the interesting question. For research, the more interesting questions are the micro questions. And I would just like to illustrate from some examples, building on work that Ali has done on poverty patterns in Punjab, to just give you a flavor of what kind of questions there are. And the more surprising thing is that we have not even begun to try to answer these questions. For example, as you probably most know, poverty is the lowest in the northern districts of Punjab, what used to be the old Rawalpindi division. These seven districts there, poverty is less than 10%. While it is highest in the southern districts of Punjab, over 40%. Why is that? Why is there such a large gap between two parts of Punjab? And also what we've been looking at is that this pattern seems to have persisted over the last 50 years. It's not yet completed, but some of the research that we're doing is seeing that in the 60s, because we find there's a very strong correlation between poverty and human development, and we have some indicators in the census on education and health. So using those, we have looked at patterns, and patterns in the 60s and the pattern today are very similar. So in 50 years, this pattern has persisted. The question is, why do the pattern persist? What is in this poverty that leads to perpetuating itself? That there's a whole literature of poverty traps, whether for groups or for countries or areas or regions. And that's a rich area for research on poverty. Another interesting, I just asked my staff today to do this quickly for me, and she had been working on education index for district levels and whatnot. So she did this for the seven northern districts. And if Pakistan had the same education index as the average for these seven districts, you see, you and DD comes up with this human development report which has the in it the education index. And Pakistan ranking would go from 169th to 54th. We would go from the company of Ethiopia, Afghanistan, Sierra Leone, to that of China, Brazil. How? That the same education system in the same province can deliver such different outcomes? This is a question, I think, again, you cannot answer this question without some basic research into what determines poverty, what determine education outcomes, what determine health outcomes. So, this is with regards to the second pillar that I mentioned. Third, recently the government has introduced this Bayh-Nazir income support program. This is one of the most ambitious social protection programs. But there are all kinds of issues of targeting, and there are issues that it should be transitory or temporary. People should be provided a safety net, and then they should be able to be helped to come out of poverty. And this again is an area of research for the center. What are the mechanisms targeting, how good they are, and are they working, and what can be done to get people out of this? Then also the fourth pillar, which Ms. Ayyarma referred to, what is the relationship between governance and poverty, and between poverty and violence, and between violence and militancy? These are today some of the key questions which Pakistan is concerned with, but we have no idea, no research exists. You can say Southern Punjab has the most poverty and therefore it has the most militancy. But this is kind of a naive conclusion one would draw. Because Sindh district, which is just above Southern Punjab, are even poorer than Southern Punjab, but they don't have militancy. But they do have violence. So these are, again, I think, issues that political scientists, sociologists and anthropologists can explore, that is something in the culture, in the structure of landholding, in what has determined these things, and how they interplay with each other. How does these governance structures result in educational and human development outcomes, and how then they influence poverty and so on. So I just thought that I would leave you with some questions which would motivate some of the students who want to do research in this in the area of poverty, and if they do, they could address some of these issues so that 5 years from now we might have a better understanding of the reasons for poverty, the interrelationship between poverty, and then how do we address and help this country to come out of poverty and move on well. Thank you.